family rocks in my green jeans.
I want to be stereotyped. I want to be classified.
I want to be stereotyped. I want to be classified. I want to...
You. You said you'd share your hoodie. Where is it? Where's the hoodie? You need to fix this. I'm doing my hoodie.
You have to start soaking your trips. They're fucking disgusting. I know you don't wash those bitches because you don't want them to fall apart. But this is only after a month of wear. They're disgusting.
Everybody out here really do be saying, I want a big titty goth GF. But get this, what about small titty punk GF?
Jersey, golf clap. Everybody golf clap for us. Come on, a little golf clap, everyone. Lowest numbers in the country, get the right people infected. I think the words you're looking for are, thank you, New Jersey. I only have one more question. If he dies, what are you all gonna buy us? Like, what are the other states gonna get us? I want a giant statue that says we're better than you. I think that's very New Jersey. I think that works. I would be happy with that. Remember when he said it was a hoax? Maybe he can give it to Mike Pence. Next up, let's get this motherfucker sick in the next month. How about that?
Fucking gay.
And why aren't you in uniform?
Since I posted my video on gatekeeping, I've been getting a lot of comments like this, and I think I need to reiterate something. Alt is not its own thing. It's short for alternative, which is an umbrella term for all alt subcultures. Here's a list of common alt subcultures. I'll leave this here for a sec so you can look at it. If you ask me for alt music recommendations or alt style tips or am I alt if I do this, I don't have the answer for you. Because it differs on the subculture. What I can tell you is this, most alt subcultures consist of music, fashion, and political views. So to Ashley and to anyone else who's asked me, here's my answer to your question. If you don't have the desire to dress or dress like that subculture, share the views of that subculture, and listen to that subculture's music, you're probably not part of that subculture. Also, if you have alt views and don't hit those other 2 points, you're just a leftist.
There's nothing I hate more than being the center of attention. And yet here I am, all eyes on me. So what do I do now?
Hello, darling. Yes, it's me, the gal with the shape that drives men ape, bringing you part two of how to be a goth bimbo. Step one, listen to goth music. Some of my favorite bands are Typo Negative, Sisters of Mercy, and Switchblade Symphony. Step two, intimidate conservatives with your sense of humor and glamour.
Listen, sister, if I wanted your opinion, I'd beat it out of ya.
Step three, donate blood whenever you can. Step four, be kind to the girls, gays, and theys.
It is never okay to tear someone else down to feel better about yourself. Just go get your lips done instead.
Step five, you can never use too much hairspray.
Stupid horse, I just fell out of the park. Oh no. Stupid horse, I just fell out of the park.
I'm sitting in my room blasting My Chemical Romance as my mom yells,
"Turn that garbage down!"
My black eyeliner streams down my face. No one understands me. Being 12 is harder than anything else, but at least I have Gerard Way.
The only kind of straight that I am is a straight up bitch.
The bass, the rock, the mic, the trouble. I like my coffee black, just like my metal. With the bass, the rock, the mic, the trouble. I like my coffee black, just like my metal.
What? Sorry, not right now. I'm busy looking at a beautiful masterpiece that God has created.
Hit the strip out of school, couldn't wait till I got out of class. Used to stare at the clock and shit. Before all this rap shit, I was gang banging and doing half knees on the cops and shit. And I'm straight from the shop, but I ball like a king up at Cali and shoot like Snow Yaka.
This is what your favorite band says about you. Part 2. Your favorite band is Blink-182, you think boner jokes are funny, and you probably watch a lot of Will Ferrell movies. Your favorite band is Tool. I'm not gonna say this to be mean, but you probably smell like hot dog water. I'm talking like, no one will tell you because they're too nice, but you do. Your favorite band is Red Hot Chili Peppers. You joined a frat, and you think you listen to rock music when really it's just alternative at best. Your favorite band is the Deftones. Probably really horny. Or really depressed, maybe both. Your favorite band is Five Finger Death Punch, you think you listen to metal. Your favorite band is 21 Pilots, and you probably collect confetti from the concerts, and you tell everyone that their music saved your fucking life. How many fucking comments this one got? If your favorite band is My Chemical Romance, you wear a shit ton of eyeliner, you probably do a lot of cosplay, and you have abandonment issues.
Tonight,
tonight,
tonight, tonight.
One step beyond.
Tylko jedno w głowie mam, koksu 5 gram, odlecieć sam w krainę zapomnienia. W głowie myśli mam, kiedy skończy się ten stan, gdy już nie będę sam, bo wjedzie biały węgiel.
Tylko jedno w głowie mam, koksu 5 gram.
So I'm
want to stop you right there, hon, before you make that embarrassing admission of being a complete and utter poser. It's like incredibly ironic that you chose that song of all songs. On top of that, Green Day has like openly stated their disdain for Trump. Like, that entire song is specifically about a corrupt conservative administration. This song may have been written about Bush, but in today's context, it's definitely about Trump. Also, punk music is, like, inherently anarchist. Like, the punk scene emerged from a working class movement that was a form of resistance against an oppressive bourgeoisie. But hey, if you want to be edgy and have contradictory politics, then go ahead, show up to the show. Just don't expect any help from me when a riot girl decides to kick your ass. You can't be punk and conservative. Also, why are your comments off? That's snowflake behavior.
And I'll be singing la 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 la. You're breaking me la 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 la. You're breaking.
1, 2, 3,
fuck it.
My darling, I love you, I love you.
Ain't nothing but a hound dog to cry all the time.
Girl, you really got me going. You got me so I don't know what I'm.
Sing, I got the new Revlon.
Everybody wants to rule the world.
You know how.
That's her thigh. I can see that from a mile away. Look how she walks. She like Drake. Started at the bottom, gave me top. And now her nigga wanna throw the hands like Millie Rock. Okay, like nigga be talking until I pull up with the top and make him hurt. She's sucking the dick and I'm fucking the bitch. And of course I made a square. Big ol'.
Hi, hun, so I'm here to educate you on lace code. So first and foremost, a lot of people still take lace code very seriously in the punk scene, but that also depends on the region. While it isn't as popular as it was in, you know, like the 80s and 90s, it's still heavily used today. Lace code is only used for black Doc Martens, and it's only applicable to ladder laces. Red means you're a Nazi and spilled blood for the movement. White means you're a white supremacist. Blue means you've killed a cop. Purple is used by gay punks to show pride. Yellow means you're anti-racist and anti-fascism. And orange is used by the sharp skinheads. The thing about modern day lace code is that it's typically mostly used by those hate groups, like neo-Nazis and white nationalists, self-proclaimed Nazi
censored
punks. I've seen people get thrown out of shows for wearing white or red laces. People have literally been killed over lace code very recently. People have been beaten for lace code very recently. It's still relevant.
Wherever you go, I won't be far to follow. Oh, I'm gonna love you so. You'll learn what I already know. I love you means you're never, ever, ever getting rid of me.
Alright, I've always wondered how people with Liberty Spikes do one thing, specifically putting on a shirt. They don't want you to know, but fuck it. I'm gonna show y'all anyways. So here it is, how people with Liberty Spikes put on a shirt.
Alright, so a few days ago, I posted a video of me shaving my head and giving myself Liberty Spikes. I didn't tell my parents that I was gonna do this, so this is them reacting to my new cut.
No way! How did you do this? That's great! That's great. I gotta get a picture.
Wow! Let me take a picture. Oh my gosh, Hannah, it looks so cool. Looks like a sunshine. Rays.
He doesn't give a damn about me. Cause I'm just a teenage dipping.
So I've seen a lot of talk about lace code on here lately, and I wanted to point something out. So, like, this is the Doc Martens, like, actual website. Ignore my million tabs. But, like, they don't even sell white or red laces. Like, look, here's just a set of laces. Look, like, red isn't even on here. That's, like, a brown color. It looks kind of red. But, like, and then, like, the white here, you're like, uh-oh. But then it's, like, brown, black, you know, like, but they sell blue. Doc said, fuck your white supremacy, fuck your Nazism, and, all cops are bastards.
They wanna see me do my dance in these $1,000 pants. Don't disrespect me in my mans. Bang! Whole lot of choppers on your ass!
These ladies are hot. They're so very hot.